With Naxxramas' release around the corner in classic World of Warcraft, let's take a look at what goes on in this mysterious cigarette. We will go over the story of Nax, how to gain entry, the bosses within, tier 3, resistances required, and some general information. As a disclaimer, I would like to point out that most of this info is based on Naxxramas in vanilla, not classic nor Wrath the Lich King, so we will have to see if these resistance requirements, boss difficulties, and other things still hold up in today's classic WoW. As buildings can talk, I'm unable to provide you with an opening quote for this video, as I did in the previous videos, but even without a quote, there are interesting things to uncover. So, let us begin. Naxxramas is an ancient Nerubian ziggurat that once resided in the Eastern Plaguelands. The Lich King Ner'zhul tore this ziggurat from the earth for his new servant kel'thuzad to use as a vessel. Other sources say Obrahim, the Traveler, a great skeletal architect, was pivotal in the conception of Naxxramas, hinting that it was altered or retooled. Kel'thuzad, the once loyal mage of the Kirin Tor, was assigned to be the Lich King's ambassador to the living. From the floating ziggurat of Naxxramas, he extends the Lich King's influence on Azeroth. After Kel'thuzad's defeat in the Eastern Plaguelands, the fortress moved across the ocean to Northrend, where it now levitates above the fields of Dragonblade. Within Naxxramas, Kel'thuzad's minions protect the inner sanctum from four different quarters. Before the Lich King tore Naxxramas free from the ground, he told kel'thuzad, "You will go forth and bear witness to my power. You will be my ambassador to the living and assemble a group of like-minded people to further my plans. Through illusion, persuasion, sickness, and force of arms, you will establish my hold upon Azeroth." As Naxxramas was ripped from the soil and ascended into the sky, the Lich King's words to kel'thuzad rang out stating, "And this will be your vessel." After the defeat of kel'thuzad in Eastern Plaguelands, Naxxramas has returned to Northrend and now hovers above the Carrion Fields in Eastern Dragonblight, where it lays siege to the Alliance stronghold of Winterguard Keep. The instance is regarded as the most difficult one of vanilla or classic, and should not be attempted without at least 40 well-equipped, preferably tier 2 or tier 2.5 armor, players. But given how relatively easy the content has been so far, we'll have to wait and see how it turns out for us and our guilds. Naxxramas is also the home of many of the most powerful items, quests with rewards such as Atiash, Great Staff of the Guardian, and all tier 3 items. The raid was originally added in patch 1.11, making it the last non-expansion instance added to the core game, as well as the last 40-man instance, as raids of the Burning Crusade are made for a maximum of 25 people. Starting at the Wrath of the Lich King, 10-player raids were also introduced, alongside the 25-player raids. In Misipan area, they added flexible raids, also known as flex raids, which allows a raid party of between 10 and 30 players, and the raid difficulty would scale based on how many players are in the raid. And in Warlords of Draenor, they added mythic difficulty raids, which were set to 20 players. To enter Naxxramas, you have to be attuned through the Argent Dawn by completing the Dread Citadel Naxxramas quest, whose cost varied based on reputation levels. If you are honored, you have to pay 60 gold, 5 arcane crystals, 2 Nexus Crystals, and 1 Righteous Orb. If you are revered, you pay 30 gold, 2 Arcane Crystals, and 1 Nexus Crystal. If you choose to become exalted with the Argent Dawn, you can complete the attunement for free. However, this requires a great deal of work. The rotation reward for the entrance quest is 1000 rep for a character currently honored or revered. The Teleport Spire is the only way into Naxxramas. After becoming attuned, one must step onto the runic circle in the center of the spire to teleport into Naxxramas' center chamber. Although glimpses of snowy terrain can be seen out the windows in each corner of kel'thuzad's room, it is important to note that this chamber is still within Naxxramas. What you are seeing out those windows is Northrend, two portals from which Scourge emerge during the encounter. Naxxramas is structured like a giant wheel. Players enter at the center of the necropolis and then choose one of four wings to progress through. First up is the Abomination Wing. This wing is filled with abominations, of course. It is likely to be the most physically intensive wing, as abominations are known to hit rather hard. The slimes there deal heavy nature damage too. The final boss is the Frankenstein's monster lookalike, Thaddeus. Then we have the Plague Wing. In this wing, players will have to deal with various diseases. Creatures known to populate this wing include bats, gargoyles, bog beasts, oozes, and ghouls. The final boss is Loatheb, some sort of fungal monster. Next, we have the Spider Wing. This wing contains loads of spiders, as well as Nerubians and a few acolytes. The final boss is Maxna, the giant spider. And finally, we have the Death Knight Wing. This wing is loaded with Death Knights, known for their combination of powerful shadow magic and raw melee skills. The final bosses are the Four Horsemen. One of the Four Horsemen is High Lord Mograine, who has an important role in the Ashbringer storyline. The Four Horsemen were considered the hardest bosses in the instance until kel'thuzad. Once the final bosses of the Four Wings are defeated, players will gain access to the final area of Naxxramas, in which they will encounter the Frostworm Saffron and the Lich kel'thuzad. On the wall of each boss chamber and various places are some frozen rune objects, which requires a word of thawing, a tradable drop from trash mobs, to defrost. Defrosting a frozen rune yields 4-6 tradable blue frozen rune items that are used in crafting frost resistance gear. Frozen runes are also consumables, behaving like greater fire protection potions, 1500 to 2500 fire damage absorbed for 1 hour. Due to the need as reagents for the craftable frost resist recipes, it is best not to use these runes as consumables. You have to beat the last boss in each wing to progress. Once you beat all the four wings, you get a chance to fight Saffron. After you beat Saffron, you may challenge kel'thuzad. There are 15 boss encounters in Naxxramas. The first full Naxxclear was done by the Horde Guild Nihilum on Mactarodon EU on September 7, 2006, 2.5 months after Nax came out on June 20th, 2006. The easiest wing is the Spider Wing, Instructor Resuvius being the easiest boss, arguably comparable to Grobulus, but Grobulus sits behind a major gear check, Patchwork. The Plague Wing bosses, Noth and Hagen, are on a similar level of difficulty as the Nupurukan, but in different aspects. Hagen is very difficult in the individual coordination aspect. Abomination Wing bosses are in the middle, with the exception of very easy Grobulus. Patchwork is commonly conceived as a hard gear check and healer's fight. The most difficult bosses, in order of rising difficulty, are Thaddeus, Loetheb, Gothic the Harvester, and the Four Horsemen. Let's take a look at the bosses in their respective location and which armor tokens they drop for tier 3. In the Abomination Wing, we have Patchwork, who drops a token for the shoulders, Grobulus, who also drops for the shoulders, Kluth, who can drop for shoulders, belt, wrists, and feet, and Thaddeus, who will drop for head twice. In the Plague Wing, we have Noth the Plaguebringer, who drops a token for belt, Hagen the Unclean, who also drops for belt, and Loetheb, who will drop 2 tokens for leggings. In the Spider Wing, we have Nupurukan, who will drop a token for wrists, Grand Widow Ferlina, also wrists, and Meixna, who will drop 2 tokens for hands. In the Death Knight Wing, we have Instructor Resuvius, who will drop a token for feet, Gothic the Harvester, also feet, and the Four Horsemen, who will drop 2 tokens for chest. And then finally, we have Saffron, who drops a powerful shoulder enchant, and kel'thuzad, who will drop 2 rings. Now let's take a look at some resistances. First up, nature. The beginning parts of 3 of the 4 wings, Plague, Spider, and Abomination, are rich in nature damage. This is good news for players who build up their nature resistance gear in Ankiraj. Don't throw it away just yet, it might still come in handy. Next up is Frost. Players will need a lot of frost resistance to fight the final bosses in Naxxramas. Kel'thuzad is a lich, but does not require a lot of frost resistance to defeat him. The Saffron encounter, however, requires a very significant amount of frost resistance, 150 to 200, but is not frost-based, like Ragnaros is fire-based. Frost resistance gear has proven to be rather scarce thus far. Luckily, the Argent Dawn has made available several armor patterns that provide considerable frost resistance, and bosses in Naxxramas drop very high quality epic frost resistance pieces. Next up, Shadow. Shadow is the third major resistance required. Death Knights and Necromancers use powerful shadow magic, and kel'thuzad has a few shadow spells as well. The final boss in the Plague Wing, Loetheb, uses shadow based damage also. Shadow resist gear can be found scattered throughout various instances, so this shouldn't be a problem. And finally, fire. Certain boss encounters need some fire resistance, like Grand Widow Ferlina and the Four Horsemen. Though with the current game, we'll have to see if these values and necessities still hold up. And lastly, let's take a look at the look of tier 3. First up for the Druid, we have the Dreamwalker Raiment. Then for the Hunter, the Cryptstalker Armor, Frostfire Regalia for the Mage, Redemption Armor for the Paladin, Vestments of Faith for the Priest, Bone Scythe Armor for Rogues, the Earth Shatterer for Shaman, Plagueheart Raiment for Warlock, and the Dreadnought's Battle Gear for Warriors. And that has been some quick info for what is around the corner for us in Classic WoW. I hope you enjoyed, thank you for listening, and I will see you in the next video.